Cody Carlson. We really enjoy having the kids over, and they learn a lot within the 3 days that they come to the university and work in the laboratory. I really want them to be interested and excited in science, particularly in biotechnology, which is making rapid developments in all areas from health to energy to agriculture. We want to be able to expose the students not just to the science in the lab that happens that impacts biotechnology, but we also talk to them about applications and things that are in the news. Over the 3 days, they were able to clone DNA in bacteria from beginning to end. So they were able to complete cloning a piece of viral DNA in a bacteria down to the analysis of the clones that they have made. So one focus is recombinant DNA. The other one is PCR amplification.
So this week at the Biotechnology Mini Summer School, students have gotten to learn about DNA cloning and PCR. For PCR, students really got to learn about designing primers that allow them to isolate a very specific part of their genome. And then they also learned that PCR, this machine over here, what it does for them is it cycles through various temperatures. So they learned about the proteins that are needed, the enzymes, they learned about the nucleotides, and that the temperatures are cycling through a high temperature to rip the DNA strands apart, and then you have to lower the temperature to allow your primers to bind to that very specific part of the genome. And then you have to raise the temperature again a little bit to start the cycle all over again. And so they learned in a couple of hours, you can go from just one copy of your particular DNA or gene to millions of copies.
So today I'm going to show you how you can pipette. So what we've got here is we've got a box of sterile pipette tips. So you just take that, you stick it in there, and it sticks on there. Close that for now because you won't need it, and set it off to the side. Now take whatever you're going to pipette and make sure that you have the right amount set on there. So for this one, we're doing 12 microliters. So you open up your little tube with the stuff you need to pipette. You push it down while you're outside. And then you go in, and then you slowly release your thumb. Right there, you've got your substance right in there. Now for this experiment, we're loading gels. So right in here, we're just gonna try to use your other hand to stabilize. And you just put it right in there and just gently place it in there, and just like that, and you've loaded your gel. And then once you're done, you click this button right here and it takes off the tip. And that's it, that's how you pipette.
So this is how gel electrophoresis works. There's not one in here now, but you would have a gel in here and the gel would be molded with a comb, so you'd have different wells to insert your sample into. You insert your sample into the agarose gel and then an electrical current is applied to the, there's a buffer over top, a liquid buffer, and an electrical current is applied. And because DNA is negatively charged, they've got a positive end here and a negative end here. And as you apply the current, the DNA will start to move through the agarose gel towards the positive current because of its negative charge. But depending on the size of the DNA fragments you have, they'll move different distances throughout the gel because like the bigger ones will move slower and the smaller ones will move faster. So it's actually pretty simple. And then you just run it for a certain amount of time, and when you're done, you stain the gel with an ultraviolet stain so you can look at it under a black light and then see where the different bands are. And the different bands will show you the size of your fragment depending on how far they traveled. And that's really all there is to it.
They were very bright, they were very interactive, very intuitive and insightful questions. So it's amazing. Curiosity is something that really excites me when I see that in the kids that participate I'm hoping that some of them do go into science and pursue a scientific career. And if one out of those 11 students that we have do that, I'd be happy.